Are you trying to become a SharePoint search pro? Today we're diving into search scopes. Let's find out how they supercharge your search and how you can change them. So what exactly are search scopes? Well, they're kind of like filters that you apply to limit what you're searching on. It's kind of like when you're on a shopping site and you use filters to limit to the category. But in this case, we're not shopping, we're actually searching for information. When you search for content in SharePoint using the search bar at the top of the screen, also known as Microsoft Search, the type of search results that are returned are different depending on what type of site you're on, but also the kind of page you're on. Let me explain. If you're on a list and you're searching for content, it's only going to show you list results for the current list that you're on. Similarly, if you're on a library, you're only going to get search results from that library. That's because the search is scoped to that particular list or library. It doesn't stop there though. If you search on a regular site, you're only going to see results on that site, unless it's one of two other options. If you're on a hub site, then the search results are going to include anything on that hub network. That means the hub site itself and any associated sites. To take that one step further, if you're on the home site as designated in the SharePoint Admin Center, you're going to search the entire tenant, all SharePoint sites. But why does it do this? Why is the search scope different depending on where you're at? Well, it's simple, to make it easier for you and the users to find what you need. If you're on a document library and you're searching, chances are you're going to be searching for a particular document. And if you're already in a library, then you probably already know that that document is going to be inside that library. The same with searching on sites. Now, this isn't always the case though. Microsoft takes the guesswork out of this to make searches relevant to the users and easy to use. The users don't have to know that there's a search scope at all. They can usually figure this out because as they search, there's going to be clues in the search bar for where they're searching. But for some users, this is going to be confusing. Maybe they're in a library, but they're actually searching for a page in SharePoint. Or they're on a site, but they're looking for content on some other site. Those situations will come up, and searches within SharePoint can be troublesome for users who don't quite understand how it all works. There's ways to change the search scope. I described the default search scopes that you see as you go from site to site or library to list. But what if you wanted to change that? You can, and here's how. So I'm on the Contoso Electronics site, which is a hub site. So, as I've mentioned before, all the searches are going to be across the entire hub network. You also see that at the search bar here at the top, search across sites. If I wanted to scope this so that it searched across everything in SharePoint and not just this hub network, I'm going to connect using PNP PowerShell to this site. And then we're going to execute set PNP search settings, search scope, tenant. And just like that, searching on this site is going to be searching all content. And refreshing the site is going to change what's in this search bar. If I click into it, now it doesn't show search in sites. It's showing search in SharePoint, which is a very big difference. If I wanted to change this back to hub, I can just rerun this command, set it to hub, and if I refresh the site, then it's searching across the sites again. But there's more things you can do to customize this whole search interface. What if we wanted to change the search text at the top of that search box in Microsoft Search? That's easy to do with a simple PowerShell command. Here's how you can do it. If I want to make it very clear to users that they're only going to search the Contoso intranet and not all sites, then I can rerun the same command I did before, setting the search scope, but also pass in a new parameter. And that's search box placeholder text. And if I set this equal to search Contoso intranet, now let's refresh the site and see how the search looks. There it is, search Contoso intranet. So there's two great examples of how you can customize your search experience that you may not have known about. You can change the search scope to better serve your users and help them find information easier. And you could also change the placeholder text so that they understand more clearly what information they're searching in that particular search box. If you want to find more information about SharePoint Search, I've got a great playlist right up here to get you started understanding and mastering SharePoint Search.